Series of X Factor. 2 days, 11 hours, 54
minutes. It's basically two and a half days. Just two and a half, less than two and a half days.
No. We're joined this morning though by 2006 runner-up, Ray Quinn. Good morning, Ray. And of course, lovely Anna. It does consume everyone's weekend, X Factor, doesn't it? It always did, Ray.
Yeah. Well, that's why it's been so successful. I was just saying there, it's an addictive TV, you know. So I've got made to watch watching the auditions. I got made to just like watching the finals, and I got made to addicted to the whole thing, because you fall in love with people and you want to see how they do. Mm.
But if you've got to come second, it might as well be to somebody who takes over the world then.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. It's good to be associated with that, for sure. I think that's what's kept me going, but no. I mean, I had a great time on The X Factor, and Leona's such a fabulous talent, so... I did have a good time.
And there's nothing that you regret at all about the whole process? You know, some people do get involved in these shows and think, oh gosh, you know, they've kind of threw me into something I wasn't quite sure about.
No, not at all. Like, you know, people doing all these A-levels and stuff like that. That's something I didn't do, because I knew I always wanted to do sort of singing and dancing and acting, and I knew that's where I wanted to go. So this was more than an opportunity for me to sort of shine and do what I love to do and hopefully make a career out of it, which I've tried my best to do so far, really.
Yeah, well, Anna, you got yesterday to meet the new judges and the new lineup. I don't know what you think of it then, Ray. I mean,
I think it's great.
Yeah?
I think it really is great. You know, keeps it fresh. You keep watching the same thing. It can get dull, but I think it's fantastic. And, you know, I think Gary Barlow is going to be an absolute, gem for to the show.
Do you know him? Do you know Gary at all?
I've met him briefly, but nothing major. But I tell you, I think, you know, he's coming from an artist's point of view, so, you know, he'll know exactly what it feels like and what it takes to when it goes wrong and when it goes good.
Yeah, he's a proper singer-songwriter, as you said earlier, Anna.
He said to me yesterday, he doesn't want to suffer fools. You know, he wants to be as honest as he can. He doesn't want to be horrible, because obviously everyone's been saying, you know, he's been the new Mr. Nasty. In fact, when I did ask him the question outright, this is what he said.
I want people to know what I think, really think. I don't want to insult them and tell them lies. I've been very direct, hopefully not cruel. I don't want to be cruel. I don't want to put people off their passion. But I've been real with them. And if that's being taken the wrong way, then I'm sorry.
And to be fair, you'll take it from him if anyone's going to say that to you.
Yeah,
I'm sure
absolutely.
You would have respected him.
Absolutely. As I say, he's gone through it all, hasn't he? As an artist, as a singer-songwriter. So, you know, he'll know what it takes when it goes wrong and when it goes bad. And I think, because we all know that his life and throughout his career has been so public anyway, I think we have an understanding of what he's gone through. And, you know, you'd have utmost respect for him, really.
He said he's exhausted. He said I should be sort of slowing down now a little bit with my career. So I've never been so exhausted but so excited at the same time, because he's had the tour, obviously. He's now got the show.
He just finished on tour, hasn't he?
He was juggling both. He was getting helicoptered out at sort of 3:30 in the afternoon to go and do the tour. What I noticed from him yesterday, he's so genuine about finding talent. He wants to give something back, and he unashamedly is saying.
Yeah, and like he said, you know, he really likes to sort of give people the right answer, and if it ain't the nicest one, then fair enough. But he's real, because he is, and he's just a genuinely nice bloke. But with the experience to go with it.
So could we just go back to your X Factor days? Let's see what you look like as a young whippersnapper 5 years ago and all that. You're 17 then.
17.
You're only just driving. You're belting it out like you're in the business years.
Yeah, do you know, even just watching that makes my stomach like turn and the nerves come back. It's weird. It's really surreal. I haven't watched that since we finished, so that was really surreal. Yeah. And I look about 12. I look the same now, I suppose, with a bit of longer hair.
You've got that quiff though. You've stuck with that, haven't you? Quite likely as well.
Yeah, that's just the way I've had it since it was came out. So why not? Yeah, you know what I mean.
Yeah, exactly. I loved you in Dancing on Ice, right? Oh, talking with you. Singer, I love Dancing on Ice. Yeah. You see, you were just brilliant on that. Like, there you are, of course. celebrate, and that was fantastic. You've had great experiences since X Factor, really, haven't
you? Yeah, and you know, the reason why I did the Dance on Ice, because it was something different. It's something like, I love a challenge, I love to put myself out there and try something that I've never really tried before and see how I go, you know what I mean? It was always when I was a kid, like, because you never know, like, what you're good at until you try it, you know what I mean? And I've got little nephews and nieces and stuff, and they try everything, like football, boxing, and all kinds of different sports, and everything really, from dancing as well. And you don't exactly know exactly what you're good at until you try it. So that's why I thought
that
to see
that.
Yeah, and I really enjoyed it.
All right, it's great having you here. Stick around for a bit.
We'll do,
please. Thank you.